G'day, I'm Dr. Peter Price of Classroom Professor. In this video, I'm going to talk about a multiplication strategy for multiplying by four, and the strategy is called double double. This comes from our book, 10 Minutes a Day, Level 2, book number 2, multiplication. So this is aimed at grade 3 or year 4 students. So the strategy is relatively straightforward. This would be done after the students have obviously done doubles, multiplying by two. They probably will have done fives, and they will also have done threes. Threes being the strategy we recommend is a double plus another set. So we're using the doubles quite a bit. It's a handy strategy. It's good for basically handling even numbers and quite a I'll come back to that because there are other numbers that we can apply the same strategy to repeatedly and look for a pattern. So the double-double strategy, obviously it only works if the student is able to double, so they must know their doubles quite securely, and some of these are going to be larger numbers, so we'll need to take a little bit more time. But the essential strategy is not that difficult. So here we have an example of 4 times 4, and of course double 4 is 8, and then we double 8 to make 16. So we've got a two-part process, I suppose. Here we're doing multiplying by 2. Here we're doing multiplying by 2 again, and the combination is multiplying by 4. So it's a straightforward matter, relatively straightforward matter of saying, can you double 4? What's 4 and 4, or 2 times 4? And that's 8, and do you know what double 8 is? Now, double 8's a number fact in the 2 times number fact, so this example shouldn't be too difficult. Over here, we have a harder one. Now, it's not easy to visualize because it's a larger number. The double 4 is not too hard to subitize or recognize by looking at it. This one's harder without actually counting them or finding, you know, patterns that are in there. Anyway, we have double 6 to make 12, double 12 is 24. So this raises more of a challenge. The double 6 is easy because that again is in the 2 times number facts. But what's double 12? So we want the students to think about 12 as being 10 and 2. Double 10 is 20, double 2 is 4, that's 24. That sort of thinking can be very helpful. Now we can enlist the help to some extent of 10 frames at this point, simply because when we put the 6 counters in here, we know that we'll have 2 rows of 5 to make the 10, and then another 2 making 12, and so the 10 frame can help us to see the structure more than just the counters like that. So it wouldn't be a bad idea. It's just another possibility here of using 10 frames to explore doubling. So you would want 4 10 frames there for this particular example. Double 6 making 12, you want another 2 10 frames underneath to show double 12 is 24. Okay, that's really all there is to it. So it's a matter of spending time on it. It's a matter of helping the students to develop in their confidence. As with all of these strategies, what we don't want to do is sort of go full steam ahead and, you know, leave stragglers in our wake, as it were. Rather, we want to take the students with us. So, as I said in the last video, a student who still needs the materials should be encouraged to use the materials, not criticized for not being able to keep up. And I know you wouldn't do that, but other children might. So we want to discourage any child from putting another one down, obviously. And if a child is still needing the materials, then let's use the materials. My ideal model for using materials in the classroom is that everybody's comfortable with materials. The teacher uses the materials, the children use the materials, and whenever you need materials to think about of an idea, to illustrate and to, you know, explain to someone else what you know, that sort of thing, that there are always materials available. There are abundant materials, and there is no negative connotation added to a child who wants to use them. Of course, you'll restrict their use in exams and that sort of thing, but I'm speaking in general terms. Okay, we've reached the end of this topic. Thank you for being with me, and I look forward to talking to you next time.